Hey guys, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. So I've gotten a lot of requests to teach more flashers. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this flasher maze. It is a full maze that goes all the way through with dead ends, and it ends up there. And this is a different flasher maze than the one that I taught in my book, Origami to Astonish and Amuse. And I actually designed this maze while I was teaching it. And it's an extra long tutorial, partly because I'm designing as I go. So it sort of shows you how I go about designing in hopes that you can actually design your own flashers and patterns. So this is gonna take a little bit of time, this tutorial. This model, just like the old flasher maze, begins with the ISO area flasher, which I start out by teaching. And then if you want, you can just try to change the lines so that they reflect this pattern right here. And that might be even easier than following my half hour tutorial, but you might also learn a lot from actually just following it. So, wanna learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. All right, so for this model, I'm going to use a 10-inch square of commie, but you could use any size square and any type of paper. So for a flasher maze that's green on top, let's begin white side up. And let's fold in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Now let's unfold and let's fold this edge to the crease. And unfold and rotate. And now let's fold this edge to the nearest crease. Now let's unfold and let's fold this edge to the last crease. And unfold, and let's fold the bottom edge to the first crease. Don't unfold. Now let's rotate, and let's fold the bottom edge to the first crease. And unfold, and now let's fold the bottom edge to this edge. And unfold both flaps. And now let's turn over right to left so the creases are horizontal, and let's fold this second crease, not the first one, but the second one. Let's lift it up, make that fold, and now we're going to fold it up to the top crease. So it's like this, line it up with the crease, and then flatten. And when you flatten, you see you're making a fold in between. So it's like that. I'm going to show you what happened. Okay, reflatten it. Now let's take the next crease down and let's lift it up, pinch it, and let's fold it onto this edge. And make sure it aligns perfectly and flatten. And now let's go down all the way, repeating like that. So lift up this fold and fold it up. And I'm going to fast forward this. And let's fold the bottom edge to here. And let's turn over right to left. And let's fold this flap down on the crease. And let's fold the edge up to the top. All right, so we have divided the square into 16. Now we're going to do it in the other direction. So notice how these two side pieces are valley folds. So this crease is going to be a valley fold. We're folding in half. And let's unfold and let's repeat. And it's the same process as before. So let's rotate and let's fold this edge to here. And let's unfold both flaps. And now let's fold this edge to the last crease. And unfold, and let's fold the bottom edge to the first crease. And this time, don't unfold. And rotate. And let's fold the bottom edge to the first crease. And unfold. And now let's fold the bottom edge to this edge. Okay, now let's unfold completely and let's turn over right to left and let's lift up not the first crease but the second one and fold it onto the first crease. And lift up the next one down and fold it up to the edge. And continue all the way down. And I'm going to fast forward this. And turn over right to left. And let's fold this flap down on the crease. And fold this edge to here. Okay, now let's unfold so we have the white side and we have this pleated fan. Now you want to try to find the middle crease. So it's going to be this one. We have three ridges on either side. One, two, three. Okay, so we have our middle crease. So you have your middle crease. And now you want to count down 7 units. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. On the 7th crease, we're going to extend that crease out to the right. And now let's go 2 creases down, 2 units down, 1, 2, and extend this crease out to the left. Like that. And now what we're going to do is make this flasher pleat pattern. And this is how to do it. You're going to just ignore this whole area. We're just focusing on this rectangle right here. And let's squeeze these two edges together like that and make these two folds. And now we're going to push the edges to the creases. So it's like we're pushing here. My hand is behind to offer support. So it's like this, and we're squeezing. And now you want to make the next pleat here and here. And continue squeezing these edges together. Like that. And now you push it up and continue squeezing. I'm pressing right on this square, lifting up. And continue. All right, so we finished one quarter, and now let's do the opposite quarter. So let's start like this and pinch here and lift up so that we're forming this crease and this crease. And now continue pinching here and push down and continue pinching and push up and down. And up and down. All right, so we finished two quarters, and now let's turn over, and now we're going to do the two remaining quarters. Let's start with this one. You see we have the rectangle here, so let's make that rectangle here and here. And now pinching right here, let's do our flasher fold. So it's like this, and my hand is underneath here to provide support. And now let's push it down. And continue pinching and up. And down, and up, and down. So it's like that. And we have one more quarter to go. So it's here, and here. So make those two edges come together right here. And here goes. Pinch. Like that, and open it up, and now just get out the little glitches, and now we're going to push it together so the center just turns like that. And as you push it together, you want to be rotating it so that it's kind of even in its distortion. And what you can do is you can squeeze right here so that you're on the crease, and then pull. And then squeeze here on the crease and pull. Squeeze and pull. That way this distortion gets forced into the middle of the flasher, which might be a little bit better. And there it is. All right, so we're done with the basic 16 by 16 grid ISO area flasher. By the way, ISO area means that it looks the same on this side as this side, except that the spiral spins in the opposite direction. All right, now I'm gonna show you a rather simple way to alter the pleats to make a basic flasher maze, and then I'll show you how to alter them further to design your own maze. So let's look at this. We want a path that's going to go through the this part right here. So let's start on this quadrant, the one that has a white square here. And let's say that we're going to have the maze start right here. That's the entrance to the maze. And it's going to go here, here. And now we want it to go into this path. So we're going to push this edge in like this. Bring these two edges together, and these two edges together. So now the path goes here, 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 and it'll come around here. And just for simplicity, let's just do this fold all the way around. So it's like this, and that'll actually make a simple maze. Okay, here we want this to become a path, so we're going to start right here. Like that, so this is a continuous path. And here. So the path goes around here. Like that. And let's continue it like this. Okay, we want this to tie together, so it goes like this. Boom, 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 boom. And now we go to here. Okay, and we're actually back at the entrance. So, all right, so here we have the basic maze. It's not really challenging. It's a simple maze. You start right here, and you go through, and right here you have a choice of either going into this quadrant or going into this quadrant by going in here, or going into this quadrant like that. So we can decide where we want the exit to be. And it doesn't really matter which is the exit, because we can just close off any other exits. So let's decide that this is going to be the exit. So let's close off any other exits. Okay, there's no exits there. This might be an exit. Yeah, let's close that off. Like that. Okay, so the solution of the current maze is like this, and around, and around, and around. Now that's pretty simple, because you're kind of going in the direction of the exit. Now I'm going to show you how to change it so that you can really alter the paths however you wish. And I'm going to show you by making a path that exits here but takes the circuitous route all the way through
all of the quadrants.
That means we're going to have to put dead ends along the obvious routes. So let's start by making the path that goes from this quadrant directly into this quadrant. So it's like that. And pinch. Okay, so now we have that path, and let's make this be a dead end. So now it automatically goes into this quadrant, but we actually want a possibility to go in here. So we can put a mountain fold right here and a mountain fold right here. And now you see they still have a choice to go here or here. Let's see if it closes. Yeah, it still closes. And it's a lot trickier because as they're coming around and they know that the end is here, they're going to automatically want to take the nearest route that will go to the end. And it's not going to go to the end when we're done. So this is our route of passage that's the good route. And we're coming around here, here. And so there we just went through. But that's kind of an obvious route, too. There's, like, what happened to this whole area. So let's try to utilize this quadrant. We can plug right here. And so this will be a dead end, like this. Okay, so let's make the path kind of zigzag like that. So I'm going to go like that, and it's going to go around like this, and zigzag like that. So now the path is going around like that, and let's give them a chance to go back in here and get a dead end. You see, they might think, oh, there's the end, so if I make a left, I'll be closer to that direction. So that's good. So we got it like that. Okay, now we're going in here. Oh, we have to close this off because we want to make it so that this is the path that they need to take in order to get to the end of the maze. So this is going to lead to a dead end. How about right here? So if they come through here and try to get to there, they're going to hit this dead end right here. And that means that this needs to go further along here. We're kind of just going outside the perimeter. And it's kind of boring if it completely just goes around the perimeter. So let's go into here. And that way, this will end up as a dead end, as it is already. But if you wanted it to be the other way, then you could just go like this. Yeah, that actually is nice. So zigzag, zigzag. And that way they go in here, the big route, and it ends up as a dead end. Okay, I like that. Okay, so we blocked this off, and we want to block this off as well. So
Let's just block it off right here. That way when they come through here, they can't get into there. And so let's make this path go around like this. And here. So this is the path that's going to solve the maze. It goes around, around, around like this. And we can push this in, maybe. We're getting kind of close to the center. Maybe we shouldn't do that. Let's see how this flattens. Okay, it's a little tricky to flatten. But it does work, it theoretically at least flattens one way or another. Okay, and it looks like this path really wants to be like that. So we go like this. And that lets it lie flat. So it's basically just experimenting with where the paper wants to go. So it goes in here and then around like that. I'm trying to fix these holes up a little bit. Okay, so there's the exit. Let's see what we have. This actually looks pretty good. So it goes around here, and this ends up as a dead end. Good. And this is a dead end, and these two are dead ends. So they finally realize that this isn't the way to go, and they have to go here and around. Okay, this needs to be attached. Like that. And this is a dead end. And this is a dead end. They're like, huh? Oh no, you gotta go in here. Around here. And there we have it. If you want, you can change this so that it goes like this, so that way this is the path, and now this can be a dead end here, like that. make sure it all collapses. Okay, let's just make the exit like this. And then this can turn into a dead end like that. Okay, so we have a nice exit now right there. And it collapses. So there's the flasher and the maze. Okay, so now that you have the maze, it's time to color the lines, if you want. This is only if you want, and I'm gonna get a piece of cardboard so I don't accidentally color my background. So I'm just drawing along the lines here really lightly. And then afterwards, I'll flatten it and go over all of the lines with a straight edge and then refold it. Okay, so now that I have all of the lines, I'm going to unfold and go over everything with this cardboard from the package of origami paper. All right, so there's the maze. And now it's time to refold it. And there it is. It doesn't really flash too well, but the real purpose of it is that you can just take it with you very compactly, and then when you want to show it to your friends, you just pull it out and see how long it takes them to try to figure out how to get through it. Maybe I'll put an arrow right here just to show that this is the entrance. And this is the exit.
All right, so there you have it. I hope you guys enjoyed folding this, and I hope that you experiment making your own mazes and patterns, and I'll see you later. Oh, and it can also be an origami tree. Bye-bye.